Welcome back. New CNN polling releasing right now shows a growing Democratic advantage when voters are asked which party they want to control Congress. The edge now in double digits, which means seizing control of the House is more than within the Democratic Party's reach. Just 12 weeks now until the midterm vote. Let's take a look at the new numbers. This is it. Which party do you want to control Congress? 52% of registered voters say Democrats. 41% say Republicans. A double-digit lead now for the Democrats. That is very significant. They need 23 seats to take control of the House. If it stays like that on Election Day, that's almost guaranteed. Look at how it's played out over the years. Democrats started the midterm election year with a double-digit lead. Then, as we got into the springtime, we had a statistical tie, essentially 47-44. It narrowed, but now as we get closer to Election Day, this is not what the White House wants, not what the Speaker of the House or the Senate Majority Leader wants, starting to stretch out in favor of the Democrats as we get closer to Election Day. In this poll, we didn't just ask, who do you want to vote for? Who will you vote for? We asked voters what's on their mind. This is Republicans, the president, the economy, taxes, followed by immigration, gun control, gun policy, health care, and trade. When you say what's extremely important or very important to you as you decide your vote in November, notice the president, the economy, taxes at the front for Republican voters. Democrats, a little bit of a different perspective here. Healthcare, immigration, gun policy, the economy, taxes, Trump, and trade. Immigration coming in so high for the Democrats is interesting. Normally an issue that animates Republicans. But in this election year, if you think back on the Trump presidency, you think about family separation policy in recent days, if you're in a place with a competitive House race, healthcare, immigration, you're likely to hear that in a Democratic ad on television.
Southern Arizonans deserve affordable health care. But in Congress, Ann Kirkpatrick joined Republicans to weaken Obamacare and supported plans to turn Medicare into a voucher program. Ann Kirkpatrick, not from here, not progressive.
Doug Chin, as Attorney General challenging Trump's divisive travel ban, even at the Supreme Court, and suing to protect immigrant dreamers from Trump's discrimination.
11 points, 52 to 41. If you're the Republican Party and you're worried about holding on to the House, a double-digit Democratic lead as we get closer and closer to Election Day, that is very bad news for the president and for his party.
Yeah, and I think what's also really bad for Republicans is what they already know, which is that what they thought they wanted to run on, tax cuts, the economy, is not working for them. It's not working for their base. And Democrats, on the other hand, have found that issue-based campaigning, specifically as you make it more local on issues like health care, does work for their base. It works almost as well as them being upset about Trump, but on an issue-to-issue basis, it is not really a fair fight. Republicans are not being mobilized quite as much by taxes as Republicans had hoped. That's going to be a huge problem for them as they go forward.
Right, it's really interesting. I've been in a number of these congressional districts, and what you see is that Democrats almost don't even need to talk about the president. It's so in the ether. It's so motivating their voters, and he's the president is constantly reinforcing all the reasons why Democrats don't like him by himself, so they can get up there. And I've been to events where they don't mention his name at all, unless, you know, maybe somebody asks a question, but in the stump speech, Trump is not mentioned. They talk about health care, they talk about immigration, they're able to talk about those issues while still getting the enthusiasm boost that the president is able to give the Democratic side.
One of the Republicans' closing arguments has been the threat of Nancy Pelosi. You see it in a lot of the ads. Now, this is a national poll, so I want to be careful. In your district, maybe it's working. You can't apply national polling. But if you look at it from a national perspective, the Republicans are not having success, at least yet, in selling this argument. Is among Republican voters, is Nancy Pelosi extremely important or very important to your vote? 34% say it is, but 60% say it's moderately important or not that important. So on the national level, Republicans have yet to break through, if that is their closing argument.
Right, and I think that to Abby's point, Republicans were hoping that, you know, a lot of the stuff they actually got done would be able to propel them. But the chaos that Trump has created, all of these competing narratives, make it so much harder to run on that. And Democrats, I think for a while, were really at risk of falling in the trap of only running against, you know, Trump, being so alarmed by everything he was doing and saying, you know, you have to vote for a Democrat because the world is burning down. They've sort of started to realize, okay, no, we need to run on actual issues. And that has proven to be more effective to them. And to the extent that they can, you know, turn that into a victory in the midterm, that will be huge, and it will start to lay the groundwork for what they want to do in the next presidential election, because right now it has looked very chaotic on both sides. It hasn't been clear whether anyone can craft a narrative about, you know, why you should actually vote for one candidate over another versus God, everything looks chaotic right now.
Everything does look chaotic right now. Again, a double-digit lead for the Democrats. They need 23 seats. If they keep 10 points or more on Election Day, they will get those 23 seats and more. You can bank that one. Look at, we live in two Americas sometimes. You ask Democrats a question, you ask the Republicans a question. So here's the question we asked in our poll. The Russian interference probe, is that extremely important, very important for your congressional vote? 79% of Democrats say it's extremely or very important to them. Only 18% of Republicans say it's extremely or very important to them. You look at these numbers, and sometimes you do realize that, at least on political questions, there are two very different Americas out there.
Yeah, and I think the most striking thing about that poll is that there's only a third of independents that seem to care about it very much at all. And that matters both for both sides of the coin, right? Because you have Democrats that are pushing, oh my goodness, look at this, there's potential collusion with Russia. You have Trump who thinks he can sometimes get a gain, frankly, from, you know, talking about how it's a witch hunt over and over again. Right. If that's just a lot of wasted air on the people who are in the middle, who you don't kind of have committed to either camp, then that's a lot of wasted air that people are campaigning on in a way, or devoting time to in a campaign season when, like you were saying before, Sarah, like there may be more ground to gain in focusing on actual specific issues that hit people at home.
I will make the reminder that I feel like I often make at this table, which is that we're only hearing 50% of the story on that investigation.
Yeah,
right. So when I look at those numbers for independents, I wonder what happens once you hear something from Mueller, whether it's a report or whatever it is. Do we see a shift? We probably won't see a shift in the Republican numbers, but that's fine. That's baked into the cake for Democrats.
But
do you see a shift with the independents?
But will that happen?
And when does that happen?
Right. Yeah, that doesn't happen in the next few months.
I do wonder if what those numbers are also showing is that for Democrats, the Mueller probe is important because, to Don Jr.'s point, if Democrats take control of the House, they will impeach the president. I think maybe what we're seeing is Democrats saying, this is important to me because it's important to me that Congress acts on whatever the Mueller probe finds. I'm not sure what else there would be that would, you know, they're not, Donald Trump himself is not on the ballot in November. The Republican Party is.
Yeah, but that's, that number from Democrats is part of their thinking about the president of the United States. You know that. Up next for us, President Trump wishes Maxine Waters a happy birthday. Guess what she wants from him as a gift.